fondness. And I think living is the mother of all suffering. For if it asks the earth to slow down for a bit and see the kind of pain we endure, it might not be able to run back on its feet. It might turn numb, for that's the kind of pain we endure. Pain looks like this broken brain is nudging through my skin. Then again, there are a gazillion types of pain. For you tell me, according to a legend, there are at least 7 people in this universe who look alike. But I tell you, there are more 2 kinds of suffering that even look close to each other. And in life's cafe, the menu seems pretty endless. But my words open all kinds of pain. Tomorrow is a Monday kind of pain. The guy at the corner looks extremely cute, but is looking back kind of pain. My favorite Pani Puri shop shut down kind of pain. What do you do to my favorite character kind of pain? Why do people leave kind of pain? Can I fall in love kind of pain? Can I trust kind of pain? Can I trust again kind of pain? She looks like a rainbow to my night sky, but will I ever tell her kind of pain? And amongst all of these pains, there's this one pain that crawls through the silent corners of my eyes and says nothing. And this is the pain of the unnoticed. For 2 years back, in the most silent corridors, there's a kid walking by with her curls lavishly adorning her shoulders, beatboxing her body. I call her out to tell her she's amazing. She turns back and tells me I'm sorry for being loud. For she must be yet another kid who was told she wasn't good enough. She must be yet another kid who was told not to try something that doesn't look like her cup of tea. For she must be yet another kid who was unnoticed. Because yesterday was a normal day. Nothing extraordinary happened. At my lunch, opposite to my table was a girl sitting who dropped her sauce and picked it up before anybody noticed. I noticed. I smiled. She looked away. That night ended like any other night. Nothing significant had happened, but I realized that night that the child in us never dies. And we are constantly demanding maturity to embarrass the child in us. And this is the pain of the unnoticed. Because yesterday, towards the bus stand, there's a school kid walking by, removing her back for a second, just to recover from a slouch, just like we pick and drop and pick and drop and pick and drop the pain that we go through. And this is the pain of the unnoticed. This is the girl in the last row of the cafe, smile lightly. This is the guy on the street light who you saw holding up your soul. This is the girl who's smoking her stress away. This is the guy yawning after a late night essay. And this is the pain of the unnoticed. And pain so categorically wrapped. In a supermarket? Clothing. Broken. Bleeding. Wounded. Do not touch. Closed. And after all this, I find 2 steps to handle pain. Step 1. Stop listening to me. Yeah, stop listening to me, but my kind of pain is so much different from yours. My pain is like fire burning the cities within me, and yours is a flood without a life jacket. My pain tastes as hard as old monk, and yours bleeds like red wine. My pain is like coffee mug shattering in an earthquake, and yours is an unbreakable storm passing through your lungs. Our pain is different. And you are your best healer. There is no light brighter than that which comes from within you. There is nothing more confident than your hand that picked yourself up. You are your best healer. Step 2. Always, 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 always remember step 1. But I look at life like a chessboard. Coins moving back and forth. And just because someone says checkmate doesn't mean you cannot start all over again. But even if pain is like a broken basement, I no longer know if it's the basement that's clinging onto me or I am clinging onto the basement. If expectations is the mother of all disappointments, then I think living is the mother of all suffering. But do not forget a little yet, because 2 years down the lane, if we ever meet again, I will tell you hi and we not let things go unnoticed.